A very good morning to students. Today we will be dealing with some literary aspect of drama. Students, you have heard about drama. How is it different from a novel? Is a matter of concern and study. Novel is descriptive and narrative in nature, while drama is concerned more with plot. And plot concerns itself with the cause, what happened. For example, the person died. It's simply a statement or a fact. Why he died, that concerns the plot in drama. The person died of cholera. So this is the cause, and that makes drama different, or the plot of a drama different from a novel. In Elizabethan age, drama was considered as a prime force, because during those times, university wits, your own Christopher Marlowe, Thomas Nash, Lilly, Green, and many other dramatists were trying their luck in the city of London. Shakespeare was their contemporary, but he went ahead with his psychological interpretation of the characters. Though he was influenced by the works of his contemporaries, but he had his own ingenuity and creativity to deliver the dramatic output in such a way that it spans not only for 3 or 4 decades, but his fame has crossed those decades and till today, even at present times, we see that people get inspired by Shakespeare. Whether it was Shekhar Kapoor in 1998 when he directed Elizabethan One, in which Kate Blanchett played the central role of Queen Elizabeth I, or whether it is our own Indian director Vishal Bhardwaj, who has directed movies like Makbul, Othello, Omkara, which are primarily based upon the plots or drama written by Shakespeare. Macbeth, Othello, and many other plays which find mention in the literary history of Shakespeare, we find that he has focused on different elements at different stages of life. He wrote tragedies like King Lear, where the egoistical king is not ready to accept his daughter's real affection just because she is plain enough. She cannot say or express her love in the terms that most of the people expect it out to be. Another example where heroes play a central role is The Merchant of Venice. In this play, Portia, in disguise of a man, she fights for her man, and due to her intellectual competence and will to gain her love back from some kind of conflict, she gains repute in our estimation. So we can say that Shakespeare was way ahead in not only treating the heroines of his times, but also the characters in a way that no contemporary could do. Though Christopher Marlowe was a good rival, you can say, in literary circles, his Renaissance-like spirit reflected itself in Dr. Faustus, but it was Shakespeare with his 37 plays and varied nature of characters that we see that the dramatic brilliance is at its peak. For example, if I want to elaborate on a single aspect of the romantic comedy element in Shakespeare, there we have mistaken identities, resolution of conflict. Now you may say that there is resolution even in tragedy, but in romantic comedies it ends in a happy note, or it ends on an optimistic note, or unification of the lovers, or you may say even marriage of the, some lovers, or you can say there are marriage ceremonies, there are couples. And not single couple, but multiple couples. Another major element that Shakespeare focused upon was the stagecraft. During those times, most of the theatres were octagonal or hexagonal in shape. So that required that the stagecraft, where the play was enacted, the audience were the part. So it was the creativity and independent judiciousness of Shakespeare that incorporated soliloquies, asides, interludes, and yes, even banquets. He was inspired by Christopher Marlowe in taking this blank verse further. So Elizabethan age is not only about the queen, it is also about the person who had the guts to take the language of literature from Middle English period, that was the prerogative of only Chaucer at times, to the times where we are standing at present. So Shakespeare's genius can't be measured only in terms of the decades, the seventh decade of 16th century, but rather it should be gauged from the fact that even today his plays are considered as prime bodies for inspiration, for music. And yes, here I am reminded of one famous line: if music be the love, food of love, play on, play on. As you like it is the play. Another famous line: the women doth protest too much. Yes, the women protest too much. Frailty, thine is women. So these axiomatic expressions of Shakespeare tell us what kind of a marvel he was, he is, and he will remain. So here I am signing off my lecture on Shakespeare and his romantic comedies. In the next lecture, we will elaborate upon the characterization that Shakespeare did, whether it was Shylock, King Lear, name any character and you will realize that that person could bounce even a very flat character into a round one. Thank you.